Grace and peace be with you. Hi, my name is Mark. I'm the pastor at Sycamore Creek in Potterville. I have a brief thought for you today for day 19 of the New Testament Challenge. We are on Mark 5 and 6 and 1 Corinthians 11 through 13. And I want to wade into the deep end today and get right into 1 Corinthians chapter 11. 1 Corinthians chapter 11 verses 2 through 16 are very confusing. Paul is writing about worship and proper procedures, proper ways to worship. And he writes about women in a way that is really confusing. Let's just be honest. It's very confusing. And at times you're like, what? You know, what are you writing, Paul? Now, he is writing about worship. That's clear. And he's writing about the appropriate appearance of heads and of hair for both men and for women. And there's a lot going on here culturally that I think we've lost. We don't entirely understand the circumstances and exactly what Paul is writing about. But in the midst of that, he writes about all this stuff with head. And it's really helpful to go back to the original Greek and look at what head means. You know, we tend to think of head as authority. So if you are the head of something, you are the authority over something. And the original word, the Greek word that Paul uses, it could also mean origin or source. And so there's definitely scholarly debate on this passage, but where I tend to side is that Paul is talking more about origin or source than he is about authority. And what that means is that this passage is not necessarily about authority and who has authority over who, but it's about distinctions. It's about appropriate behavior in worship. We don't fully understand the hairstyles and the things that are being talked about in this passage, but when Paul talks about something being the head of something else, he's talking about origins and one thing leading to another, and he's bringing us back to the creation narrative where Adam is created first, and then from Adam, Eve is created. It's an origin story. And that's an important way to look at this because we can get really tripped up in what Paul is saying here otherwise. The important thing to remember is that Paul is giving us right procedures for worship, and he values worship, and he values worship in a way that helps us to focus on God rather than to get distracted and caught up in other things. And today, as you worship, as you read through this, may your focus be on God, on listening to God's Spirit, and to not get distracted by some of the things that Paul writes about. God's grace and peace be with you.